Well, a teenage graffiti artist has been killed inside a train tunnel in Sydney's inner west.
TEN's Andrew Denny joins us from Lewisham Station. Now, Andrew, this really is a very sad reminder of just how dangerous this illegal activity can be.
Well, Kat, the trains here move just so quickly in such confined areas. 18-year-old Trey Toman was painting under an overpass last night when he was hit by a train. The tunnel he was in was just 3 metres wide. And today authorities have said while all of this is a tragic waste of life, no one should be venturing into such unsafe areas.
Trey Toman left a lasting mark on many.
Always in the bottom of our heart, you know what I mean?
But this was his final mark. Tags on the walls at Lewisham painted moments before he was hit and killed.
Said he was on the tracks here and an inner city come past and took him, cleaned him up.
Just after 9:30 last night, a train driver reported hitting something going through a narrow tunnel. Trey had been tagging there with 4 mates. They ran away before reporting it to police.
Incidents like this have tragic circumstances, tragic ramifications. Those young people shouldn't have been in the tunnel. It serves as a warning to everybody, do not be where you shouldn't be.
But many blame the government for knocking down legal graffiti sites.
Surely we can have more walls around New South Wales for kids to express themselves.
All the ones in Rydalmere, Balmain, they're all gone. We used to paint there every day. If he still painted there, he wouldn't be on the track.
Locals say they see vandals on the tracks around here almost every night. Much of the graffiti here is regularly painted over, but it's back within days.
Today, friends return to the scene to lay flowers and remember.
We lost a good friend and he's a genuine person.
His mates, who paint here too, now want the carnage to stop.
Well, I've lost about 5 mates down in this same area, doing the same thing. But no one seems to wake up. They just keep doing it.
Andrew Denny, 10 News.